10 seconds remaining.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back into Mr. Cat Season 2. It's the playoffs, the second round of the upper bracket. It is Geek Fam versus Clutch Gamers. Game number 2 now underway as we head into the draft here on Moonduck TV. My name is Munch. Joining me today is Trent. And man, Trent, I gotta say, Clutch Gamers, they look pretty damn good in that first game. Uh-oh, team speak.
5 seconds
You're muted.
Why do I do this?
It happens to me all the time, dude.
I'm just going to stop. And then, you know what? When I start making noises during the break, you can just mute TeamSpeak, and then I won't have to worry about it.
Yeah, so that's fine.
That's going to be the life now. I know. You're on the ball, and I'm just here at, like, doubting you for some reason. Like, what's my problem? What's my issue?
You know, listen.
Who knows?
I deserve to be doubted from time to time, but I got
well, that was... There were some two pretty serious win streaks. I was just noticing. I mean, CG, they were on a 4-game win streak before that last game. Now that's 5. And GeekFam, they were on a 6-game win streak. Hadn't lost a match at all.
Zero.
Now it's 0.
Just that was... like that. By the way, guys,
I got that little sign. This team has played Dota for, you know, X days without a loss.
X day without an incident, without a loss. It's now 0.
It's gone.
By the way, guys, if you want to be able to watch in Dota TV, make sure you find your D2CL Season 6 ticket. I have no idea how you're going to buy it.
Yo, fuck off.
But go get it.
I do it for the stats, okay?
Listen.
I saw there was a Reddit thread that told Valve to start please adding tickets again,
which would be great. Yeah.
I don't want to do this, guys. I'm sorry.
Listen.
The real mystery is how I even wound up with this ticket. I didn't cast that season.
10 seconds.
I think I did stats for it, like,
yeah, you must
when
have.
I was first starting out for like
Five
one game, and
remaining.
Somehow the admin system put me as a tournament admin.
I think back then you had to be added manually.
Yeah,
so somebody
yeah,
just
I know.
Added you manually.
I have no idea why or how, but it's great.
Well, yeah, we got this going. I mean, if you didn't have it. I guess we would have to use I might have Captain's Draft.
I know. I'd have to be like logging in.
Wait, hold on
like...
a second. I might have Captain's Draft from this account.
10 seconds.
So.
But it's.
God.
It's too. I didn't have anyone when I was doing the tournament,
Five
though. And now at least they're all in one place.
It makes
more sense to leave it.
I'll try. I want to make a lobby next game just to determine whether or not I do have Captain's Draft, which I.
No, you do. We checked.
Oh, I do?
Yeah.
Then why are we doing that?
Because you weren't
leave it
here for the
ticket,
first
right.
day.
You want to leave it for the first. You want to leave it on the same ticket.
Yeah, then it's easy to find.
Well, I mean, the stats are still going to be screwed up because it's D2CL Season 6.
No, my friend. The point is because when it's a ticketed match, it automatically gets parsed by all the websites.
Yes,
if you don't put a ticket on. So that's the issue.
But, all right.
And at least now they're all in the same spot. I think it makes the most sense. Just
I'm just saying if we wanted to put one game randomly... on the captain's draft ticket, we could do that. That actually triggers so many people trying to find the best of three series, and then, like, game two is just not there. It's like on captain's draft, you have to go looking for it. You're like, what happened?
I mean, who else is going to use this ticket? I pretty much own this ticket now, you know? This is like me, except it looks like someone else was doing some weird.
I wish I had this admin ticket, because then I would just start doing it just despite you. I would just randomly go into the lobby games and get, like, an in-house going and just have a D2CL Season 6 ticket going. Anyway, there is a, guess what, Trent?
What? It's CM. It's Boombox CM, and then they'll take up that Darkseer for themselves. So that's interestingly enough, I have to say, CG, let me get my bearings here.
Radiant
CG chose second pick in game number 1. They had the first choice overall. They chose second pick. Crimson over here on GeekFam, they wanted first pick. Every team that I've been seeing, they prefer the second pick lately, but yeah, not these guys. So GeekFam maybe taking the less trodden road here, and but as I said,
Jug first 2 picks overall. That's nuts.
Yeah, that's pretty strong. I'll be happy with that.
But even so, isn't it like to pick Jug second after you? I get the Weaver pick first.
5 seconds remaining.
I mean, you're kind of like you're telling them what you're doing with your lineup.
Reserve time
in terms of mid safe lane type ideas.
That is true. It is a bit unusual. The other thing is that there could be. At least what I would say is that with that Weaver being picked up and then they see this Darkseer, they're thinking about just putting this Weaver as like a support possibly. And then they do this like Juggernaut just goes laning up against the Darkseer because he's like one of the best heroes for it. But As he said, it is pretty weird to reveal your assumedly mid and position one so early. Could also be like an offlane weaver as well. We've definitely seen that in Mr. Cat. So I think the approach from Clutch Gamers is just ban out the some of like the better position fours. Maybe trying to push them in towards that position four weaver might be good, because it's not really going to work well with a drow with a jug already in your lineup. And yeah, we'll just go from there. But CG, on the other hand, they have a very strong, synergistic, classic draft. They got the Crystal Maid and the Darkseer. She shores up those new nerfs that ruin his mana pool. We got Darkseer Sven, Wombo Combo, the classic. Yeah. And then we got a Shadow Fiend.
There is a lot of combo potential here with Clutch Gamers. Not only that, they're very tanky between the Sven and all the other heroes. They'll have a mech for the Darkseer as well at some point in time. Remaining. We might see that good old Darkseer Helm of the Dom. Where that Skylark played. I mean, I think other Darkseers have played it too, but Skylark was the one that I saw play it, where you just have a Centaur Conqueror, some other creep, and then you vacuum into it and find a nice disable.
I think one of your favorites, MSS, was actually the first person to play in a ticketed match,
right.
I recall.
Yeah, you were talking to me about that. Hey, Arif is, he's pretty good about coming up with those types of things. He's also pretty good about watching anime, so two really good aspects for MSS.
Well, it seems that with the Invoker pickup here, then we will indeed be having either a support or an offlane Weaver. So either you do this like offlane style where he has to build into this Aghanim Scepter is the goal. And then that would probably lead you towards at least guessing that it'll be a Quas Wex Invoker. So you can have more team fight and more control versus the more just like Exort style one. But we'll see.
He had a pretty good time in lane. He was the highest net worth hero for Geek Fam with Teehee playing it. The question remains if he could do it again, and if this time they can have a better time in doing so. We'll wait and see. I gotta say, I like the combo potential from Clutch Gamers right now better. I haven't seen too many support weavers as of recently. I'm sure it's still getting picked, but it's not something I've seen go head-to-head with drafts like these.
5 seconds remaining.
And what are we looking for our last pick for Clutch Gamers? They have their 1, 2, and 3, so probably just their 4-position support.
Reserve time.
Or 4 or 5, and then Geek Fam, they're looking for their offlane or support or something.
Dire
like that.
Team pick.
Pudge was a good ban.
Yeah, it was. It was a solid ban with CM Sven. It's very, very good. Wonder what else they can pick in the support role. But Geek Fam here, as you mentioned, this could be a Weaver support, so then that means we'll be seeing the offlane for Geek Fam, or it could be a offlane Weaver and pick a support in their last pick. I'm not sure what they're going to do. What options are there?
For Geek Fam, I personally don't really like the offlane Weaver. I haven't seen a lot of success with it because I think it makes your initiation really weak.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if they have this Juggernaut, Invoker, Weaver as a trio, like, you need someone super strong initiating. You need, like, an Earth Spirit or something in your four role, or a Slard. I think it's that quick blink, and there's just not many heroes that can really do that for you out of that role. So I would lean in more towards some sort of an offlaner.
There's a lot of them that have been taken out of the pool. The biggest being like Centaur and Axe. And I could, Clockwork's like one of those rare situations where this might be an okay game for him potentially. I don't know. Against this Fen, maybe.
I think
not.
Nyx is actually okay. This is actually a pretty good Nyx game.
Yeah, that's pretty nice actually.
CM, Darkseer, Sven, Shadow Fiend. You can disrupt that combination of the vacuum. You would have Sunstrike ganks as well with Vendettas.
I'm with you on the Nyx Assassin, buddy. I think it's a good choice for them. 6 seconds left. They're trying to decide what they want to get.
Tidehunter.
Of course.
Wow.
How could we forget Tidehunter?
Radiant team.
Oh, he's a dead hero.
He's back from the grave. Very good against, I think, this fan early on in the game.
He's floating to the surface. I don't know. He's okay. I mean, he's a combo breaker with a 150-second cooldown instead of the Carapace cooldown.
10 seconds remaining.
I mean, that's what I would say right now. You prefer the Nyx Assassin. Wow. It's the Drow Ranger.
Is that a support, Sven? Yo.
It actually what up? Might be.
So he'll just be here to, like, counter the minus armor.
They switched that up
Weaver.
Quickly.
They
wow.
did.
That's crazy.
All right. Well, I mean, that works with the Darkseer, though, because he'll be, like, this position 4 bully that you can still Iron Shell, and then you just... He just runs at you with Stormhammer. It's like bullying the lane with the Darkseer, and you can still do the combo potentials.
And you have the Arcane Orb, Crystal Maiden, the old Brilliant Sora. So Sven now is like, yeah, early on in the game, you're going to want to carry some Angers and Clarities, but later on down the road, the Arcane Orb is going to help loads in terms of him getting his mana back. So I don't know. I feel like Drow is still susceptible to Gangstrelion with Sunstrike and Lift. Perhaps Gush.
5 seconds.
This is a very interesting game and a very interesting draft as well from Clutch Gamers. It's not what I was expecting. Not what I don't think anybody was expecting.
No, that was pretty unusual. Last pick, Drow here, but now it gives an even extra edge to RML in the mid lane, and he has time and again shown to be a guy who can really take over in the lane and kind of propel his team to victory. So, be looking to do that here once again. This is a
fly solo Sven.
Yeah, he looks pretty baller.
Sven.
Yeah.
Cool looking
dude.
Yeah. Wow, that is a sick set. I like that. He looks way better in this set than he does in his normal attire. Sunstrike again will spout out that there is a smoke of deceit happening, and Geek Fam will do the same. They will head with Raji down bottom on the support Weaver to get a ward up here on the Uber Cliff. Meanwhile, ward is placed by Fly solo mid, right underneath that tower. He's yet to skill anything up. He has a Windlace.
We'll see. They do that ward a lot, though.
This one mid.
Yeah.
There's a good chance that it's going to get dewarded.
Like, they always do it either there or over here or, like, here. So I wouldn't be too surprised to come see him, like, drop a sentry in the mid here.
Yeah, especially if they were able to look at some of the past replays here. Even in between games for Geek Fam. They have the sentry on Crimson. Whether or not they use it, we'll wait and see. But Teehee starts Exhort. So, we'll see. Sunstrike just to get vision. They did this exact same thing last game with Teehee, except they were on the Radiant side. So they spot out the fact that Hana is top. That's really, really good. Like, Sunstrike, if you have enough, like, if it gives you enough vision, you can determine who's going where and set your lanes up based off of the Sunstrike information you get.
Yep. Anyway. Definitely in the play.
Man, aggressive wards. One over towards the shrine, the other in towards that pole camp. So
means they're probably going to have a lot of support time down bottom, or else there's no point having these wards down here.
I imagine they're going to be pretty aggressive.
Yeah.
With Death Sama.
Probably Raji doing a lot of this like jungle dancing. kind of stuff on the Weaver here, and because top lane you can have this Juggernaut, you have him up against the Darkseer, you can basically be relatively fine, especially once you get into the healing ward. And once it's like the third point in the Iron Shell, it still gets really annoying, but that's a long way away and plenty of time for the supports to do some work elsewhere first.
Boombox is going to make sure that these creep camps spawn. He has a sentry, he's not going to drop it yet. Meanwhile, Crimson still has he already used the sentry. Looks like he wasn't successful, either that or he gave it away. Perhaps to see him. So it's going to be an interesting start. Swarm coming through. I think he's jungling with it, as you mentioned. This is interesting. Jungling Weaver with Swarm.
Oh, yeah. This one's kind of funny. Yeah, good start, though. Not like you can do much with just like level 1 Chikuchi anyway, so you basically, it's like a Pudge, right? Where like if you have Rot level 1, maybe you can make a quick play. So like on a First Blood or something, you might be able to play with the Swarm or Rot, but then after that, you just want level 2 as fast as possible. So in this case, they just start right away, just get that level 2.
Fly solo did ping him and did this little circle around Raji. It was pretty much that circle. So they know that something is going on over there. They might have seen the Swarm with the Observer Ward. I think they did, actually. The Swarm came to, like, here. Like, came
right what it was.
The tower, so they probably saw it with the Ward. I don't know how important that is, considering the fact that it's just a Sven going over at level 1. I'm not sure how much he could do. Stormhammer damage.
Well, he can soak the experience.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing. Wait, screen problem. Monitor problem. No problem, baby. Black screen. That's weird. That's a very weird issue to have. You don't usually expect monitors to be the problem in the game. Whatever, I guess.
Looks like Fly solo. We'll see if he leeches any of this experience. Oh, nice. Wow, this is super sick for Raji and very important for Fly solo that he gets in here. This is the best camp as a Weaver doing this. It's so much experience, and that Fly solo just comes and ruins it. But at least he was able to stack the wolf before killing it. So he has that range available. It's not like Fly solo just like sit here the whole time. Like, yeah. What are you going
to
do?
You have to move at some point, especially when you see Raji moving down to the bottom lane. I gotta say, the way that they're set up here for Geek Fam feels like they have a very good chance here in the early stages of this game. Armel's getting dual laned against, essentially. Bottom lane's getting some pressure put on. Boombox.
Ooh, Boombox.
I think this is first blood.
That was his clarity, too.
Yeah, he's donezo, and Raji just comes right down, drops the swarm up. Fly solo will come in a bit late and get Anger Smash for his troubles. So, very good start so far for Geek Fam here in game 2, Trent.
Yeah, and this is what happens too, because they always pressure mid for Armel. Like every time level one Fly Solo goes mid, he punches the enemy mid laner a bunch, they do their thing. Man, some great teamwork, by the way, as we're watching the CSing under the tower. This is pretty sick. They just got every last hit under there.
I missed it.
Fly Solo helping with like some right clicks, and then a Bing would hit like right away. They were like teaming up on that shit.
I feel like with the Drow especially, it's not easy to last it early on in the game with this hero.
No, especially when you're being pressured.
Yeah.
But
so it's not great.
With all that pressure mid lane, it didn't give any space to Boombox. Like, he's just now getting level 2. 2.5 minutes in on Crystal Maiden, which is pretty shitty.
Yeah.
Not a fun time.
Not only that, but look at Armel's CS. It's sitting at 4 to Invoker's 13. So the Rubick being here has done a great job. And the biggest thing is, too, is what you were talking about. It's a Darkseer versus a Jug top. Yeah, they're going to go in. Sunstrike. Armel might get caught with this. He will.
Oh.
He gets it done again. That was a great positioning from that Sunstrike. Now bottom lane. Weaver Shikuchiing out. They've got the Swarm. They won't dive on Obbing. Maybe. There's a Creep Wave coming. Deathstomp was looking for an Anchor Smash. He'll take some tower hits, but he's pretty tanky with the PMS. This is, again, a very good start for Clutch Gaming. Or Geek Gaming, excuse me.
It's a pretty cool synergy in this dual offlane, too. We're running this Tide and Weaver. Like, imagine that Swarm stacks up. You give him the Anchor Smash and the Gush. Like, he doesn't even have a point in cracking. He's crazy, dude.
Baby.
He's got a poor man shield. We didn't even comment on that.
Oh, I mentioned it. He's tanky.
Oh,
so.
I am sorry.
He's tanky.
This is not the Tide item, like, ever. But this allows you to just skip Kraken Shell. You just don't get any points in it. You just get all your Gush and your Anchor Smash instead.
Remember,
Pretty great. You
used to play Tide back in the day, and if you got, like, a Stout or Portman Shield with Kraken, like, they'd be like, you have Kraken Shell. What are you getting this for? This is not the item. Now it's a new thing. It's a new meta. Here comes Raji, Shikuchiing out. They're gonna go. Good Stormhammer. Swarm's gonna come through. Boombox gonna go for a TP. Sunstrike, it's in time, but the TP actually gets him out. We see the Titan's P. One more auto attack. They get the kill. Fly Solo already used the Warcry. Might trade one for one here, but Obbing does get the kill on the Deathsama. So finally, they're turning it around here for Clutch Gamers. And remember, this is a team that plays very well from behind, as we've seen so far in this tournament playoff.
Where's your Kraken Shell? Stupid tie. That'd be me if I was that Sven. I'd be like, yeah, that's what you get. Get my full right clicks off and chain stun you. No Kraken coming out whatsoever.
God.
A little bit annoying, I'm sure, for Deathsama, but this is designed to be a very aggressive lane, and that's the way they're going to try it once again here. Wow. And top lane, we have reached that level 5 now for Rappy, though, so. Third level of Iron Shell, pretty obnoxious, but Xeonix is committed into 2 full points in healing more, so it's
Sunstrike,
a little bit easier.
He will dodge it, but he's still in trouble hobbing. Dead in the bottom lane stick. A couple more auto attacks. He might actually be able to live here for a moment. There's no TPs coming in. While this is all happening, Crimson's getting chased down. Raji will fall, but he doesn't get the experience. Now Crimson telekinesis into the Roche pit, actually stunning Roche in the process. So it's a 2-for-1 exchange across the map. Deathsama will helm him. He's full HP. His Arcane's down too, so. Not the worst trade in the world for Obbing bottom, but he does end up falling.
Yeah, I think that's fine. I think they'd be happy with that if they're the Dire. Uh-oh.
I think it's time to get a new monitor, guys.
It seems like it.
It's a very strange issue to have. It's very weird.
Sometimes your monitor just breaks, you know?
Maybe it's not the monitor this time. Maybe it's like lag or something or frame drops. Who knows? But, Trent, I'm going to talk about it again.
Okay.
Clutch Gamers have been down like 2k at the start of every single game, pretty much, and it's looking that way again. And they've come back every time, or at least almost. They were down pretty far in game number one of the series yesterday against Warriors Gaming. They weren't able to complete the comeback, but they were very close after having some good fights. I just feel like this is a team that has excellent coordination. And not just that, their hero picks are good. They know what they need to do. Again, it's that 10 to 20 minute window where they have a very good understanding of what they need to accomplish across the map, what they need to find in terms of kills and farm, and when they know what they're strongest. I have to say, Clutch Gamers, if I had to put a team up there to win this tournament, that at least right now, how it's looking, Clutch Gamers are looking really good, even though they're down in this game, but also Faceless, of course, is the favorite for everybody after dominating Execration yesterday.
Yeah, I think these two teams, as well as Faces, are three very strong contenders. Honestly, it's a very close tournament. Like, I'm really looking forward to how these playoffs play out. I'm excited to watch Mineski and TNC when TNC return from Star Ladder.
That is going to be a good game. I'm excited for that.
TNC, I mean, they took down, didn't they take down Secret?
I believe so.
Yeah, man, that's pretty hype.
They did very well in that tournament, I think. It was just somehow did very, very well for themselves. Let's see here. TNC, yep, they beat IGV 2-0. They beat Secret 2-1.
I mean, they lost to Liquid 2-0. Like, oh no. You know what I mean? Like,
a fun fact about that: those two games, they lost to Liquid in 31 minutes and 30 seconds. It was 31 minutes and 28 seconds for the first game, 31 minutes and 39 seconds for the second game. That's kind of nifty.
That is a little nifty.
The same time. That's crazy. And they were completely different drafts from Liquid.
Well, we're back.
Hey, I mean, I'm just throwing out those random Mott stats. Listen.
That was good. I liked
it. Mottistic stats are there, everybody, if you need them. Anywho, back in the game. And again, it's not great for clutch gamers, but it's not the end of the world either, as you know, Hana top lane is getting some very good farm. And Armel's starting to sort of catch back up, but he's getting a lot of jungle creeps instead of actual creeps in the mid lane. So the Invoker is clearly doing very well for himself. His Midas is close to completion. Very good ward they dropped down here. Raji down in the bottom lane, who now also has a medallion as well. Level 2 Shikuchi, and they're looking to put some more pressure here on Abing. And
yeah, man.
This is going to be difficult for him to survive if they decide to make a decision. This will
come in handy. Well, this is where the value of support spend is supposed to come in. It's that naked medallion we always see from these Weavers. Let's see if it works here again.
Telekinesis, Warcry needs to go, and it will. Anchor Smash coming. Ravage used, and they get it onto two. The Sunstrike will follow as well. Good Stormhammer. Fly Soul is pretty speedy. Death Summa has to dive. Frostbite, it's available. They'll use it. Death Summa still pretty tanky, though. Raji, they can't find that second kill. Ravage expended, but it is the Drow that is brought down, and somehow Fly Solo stays alive Radiant's after that Ravage is expended.
Damn, that's crazy. All that minus armor. They chew right through the Warcry, even.
Yeah, it was not a great situation for Robin. They back up, though. Now he is going to get some more room to work with, but net worth-wise, he's below the Jug. Jug is actually not having that great of a time. And Armel's caught up pretty significantly. Okay.
Yeah, Rappi is very farmed up here on the Darkseer. Almost into the Helm of the Dominator. Not very far away at all. Like 25 gold.
Get that Centaur.
Mm.
Get the MSS Helm build going.
I mean, it's just crazy that you can just put this Iron Shell on the Centaur and run at people. Pretty fun.
That's actually another thing that I completely didn't even think about. They're going to make it go in bottom. Raji's sitting here in the wings. He's not going to be spotted. Raji's very close to getting seen. I think they saw Boombox and Fly Solo with the ward as they rotated through. I'm not sure, though. If that's the case, you can see the Tide is backing up. That's someone's not looking to get jumped on here.
Man, you want to be aggressive with this, Sven? And look what they have to do with him. Like, I hope it works.
Good silence keeps him alive. And he should be able to get back to the tower. And they get the storm too. Man, support Weaver.
I mean, you saw that though. That's a single use of Warcry, and they didn't do any damage to a Bing that time. Just with the help of the Rubick there and a little bit of magic damage added. It's quite fine. Top lane, they're trying to set up here on the Raffy.
Do they have Omni Slash? They should. They do. Center Conqueror Stomp. Actually, it's stolen. Psionics has his own helm.
Oh, that was pretty sick.
That's nifty. And Hana's just going to be like, well, I guess I'll have to go to the other hard camp.
They just steal right back. Okay.
Dark Troll Summoner is the item if he wants to get another creepy can. Iron Shell for Hana. Wow, he's just being aggressive. Raji bottom lane is drawing a lot of attention, I feel like, for clutch gamers.
I mean, what can they do against him?
I don't know. Does he have level 6 yet? Nah, but he's close. They have Frostbite. I mean, they have ways to bring it down if you get detection, which they
Ravage
don't.
Is back up now.
This is a dangerous push. From clutch
yeah,
gamers.
They have Sunstrike too, so they can definitely get a kill
TV
here.
Coming in, it's going to be from the Juggernaut. Gust should be available. It's going to be a great use of that Gust. Omni would go. It wouldn't get the kill if so, as he TP's home. Actually, TP to the tier 1 tower. Smartly, he wants to stay around and fight. And I think Defsama doesn't know this. He'll see him now. He'll see the fact that the Drow is still there and decide maybe not to go for that push. Top lane, they're going to use the Boulder Smash. Hana coming in, backing back. There's the stun from the Telekinesis. The Iron Shell should get the job done. Nice follow from Hana. Nice key. And they'll be able to take that and maybe push the tower with it.
It's actually so ridiculous. Just IHL this golem.
Oh, that's a scan. That's successful.
Oh, look at this. Little
boombox.
Little sneaky creep.
That took a lot longer than I think you would like it to as he TP's top. It's going to be a tier 1 tower taken down by Heat Fam. Top lane, however, it's a trade. As Hana and Fly Solo are, they've got the Warcry. TPs could come through, but I don't think it's going to be the case. They will get the last hit to Hana. So trade, tier 1 tower for tier 1 tower.
And our highest farming Darkseer. Just rapping, pushing. I mean, this is kind of like old school Beastmaster where we had this guy who would just sit in the jungle. You know, remember we had that entire phase of Beastmaster being like first pick, and you picked him, and he sat here, and he just like pushed bottom, and he had these birds flying, and you could never kill him. I think Rappy's gonna kind of do the same thing up here. He's just gonna like Iron Shell in the wave, and he'll have this Helm creep like running around scouting and stuff, and then if you try and get him, he's just gonna like surge away. Their best control is like Ravage.
Oh my, that Sunstrike comboed up with the Omni Slash was exactly what Geek Fam needed to try to pressure this tower.
May, thanks.
That was fantastic. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Well, that's one way to do it.
But look at this golem, though. Like, he just Iron Shells it and runs it in. It eats the whole wave.
It has 1400 HP, too, and it's just about outlived his usefulness. There's a ward that will scout out Hana and Boombox. They might know that Boombox just dropped the ward himself. He's about to get chased down by Raji. Shikuchi's there. He has no time lapse, so I don't know how far he's going to go. They want a Frostbite. They can't use it yet. Boombox is really just trying to avoid as much damage as possible. Tier 1 tower. It's going to get cleft up. SF has TP'd in. Freezing Field coming out. Raji now has to back himself with Shikuchi, so that's down. Xeonix will get the last hit on the tower. If they want to fight, they'll have to do so without a tier 1 tower to use. Crimson might get backed back in. They can chase him down. He has a TP out in DB. There's the telekinesis. And that'll be that. And they'll just have Obbing just back down bottom. So they lose the Shadow Fiend. They lose the tier 1 tower. Good moments here from Geek Fam. Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
It's not a, don't worry. It's not a screen issue. Don't worry.
It's the other team this time. All right, good.
Just some weird pause. They had a similar pause in game one. Just pause for half a second. It's probably Dyer's something like I need to wipe my hands, wipe the sweat off my hands. Or
cat on keyboard.
Yeah, kind of. That kind of thing, exactly. Smoke is not going to be seen. At least I don't think it will be by this ward. Or either ward for that matter. So Clutch Gamers will run up towards the high ground at the shrine area. They want to drop a ward down. They want to get some vision and see what's going on with Death Sama and the rest of the crew. They're going to spot Raji and Death Sama. They don't know.
I wonder if they know he has no Kraken yet.
Well, probably.
They probably do.
Stormhammer, he actually gets the Hood of Defiance off before that comes. He's dead anyways. So him down. 28 seconds, no Ravage. Raji, I think they know that he's there. Vacuum, they break the trees as well. Shikuchi's going to be used. They've got the Sentry. Frostbite's going to go. Time lapse is not going to be skilled up. He's only level 5, and they blow him away with another Stormhammer from Fly Solo. So two dead, and they're going to transition this not only to a tier 1 tower tramp, maybe into a tier 2.
Everything's looking pretty well for Geek Fam. I think the Weaver is kind of an issue. Like, he hasn't done much in the past 3 minutes or so. He's kind of getting this vision, but as I said, he's still not level 6. He hasn't progressed past his medallion at all. He's definitely not going to get up into any sort of, like, an annoying stage in a long time. He doesn't even have his brown boots.
From Death Summit, but they know it's coming. They have Ravage. The Gust is there again, but they have the TP on Armel canceled. They'll at least get one out of this. Good attempt to the Shadow Amulet, only to die to the Blade Fury. Top
they even put a sentry down. How rude.
They're gonna get this. Yep. Crimson's about to. No, he actually doesn't have it. They used the sentry on the other, the wrong side. See, he, by the way, was split pushing top. He's trying to do some work. He gets the tower. And then he just backs in. Working on his axe. He's very close. He is a hero that I have not seen any of in this game, pretty much.
Yeah, that's fair. Just Sunstrikes. Yeah. Doesn't really need to show up. But yeah, back to Raji a little bit. It's I guess the reason I bring it up is because with a lot of these support Weavers, you'll often see them even just like getting boots, for example. Definitely pretty common on core Weavers to skip the boots.
Oh, this freezing field. Oh my, boom right. Box.
Wait, what? How
they
that
had
even
the Iron Shield creep there as well with the Seder Banisher Purge. So it was
why.
Frostbite Purge from the Seder Banisher with the Iron Shield on top of it into the freezing field. That is some serious bang for your buck on a support CM.
Well, goddamn.
Goddamn, indeed.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Defense being mounted, perhaps.
Oh, nice deny. Dire's middle tower. All right, Roger's recovered, guys.
He's back in.
Saved his game right there.
They're going to go for Roche while Psyonix tries to push bottom. He doesn't know where they are. The Dire will scan on Roche, but remember, if you're in the Roche pit, the scan doesn't work, so they attempted to see if anybody was outside of the pit. It's not the case. They're going to go in there anyways. They'll drop the swarm down.
What? Why is the whole creep wave in here? What is happening?
I don't know. Just now, they're going to find Raji back in, but there is going to be a Ravage. Saving his life, Sunstrike. They do drop that beautiful mech, but they do bring down Hana first and foremost, and now Fly Swivel might be next as well. Good Ravage. They get everybody healed back up. They will kill the Weaver at the very least, but now it's going to be Geek Fam trying to take this Roche. They don't have Ravage, just expended Obbing, Dragonlance. He's sitting right around the corner here, and Geek Fam don't see him. Meanwhile, Obbing will see them head into the pit. Really wants to make sure they're baiting it. Telekinesis, Zombie Slash. There's going to be the Sunstrike. Obbing not dead yet. Still somehow alive. Will finally fall. Psyonix doing a good job. Double race from Armel. This is a bad fight. But the Freezing Field comes out. Boombox. They do spell steal the Stormhammer. Psyonix, the race comes in. Armel gets the double kill, and they're not done yet. Good Stormhammer. Fade Bolt. There's going to be the Deafening Blast. Armel, two last hits will do the job. Two auto attacks. The Swarm doing some work as well. Crimson, no Fade Bolt, no mana. Can they get out of this alive fly solo? They smoke as well right after. Now Hana is back up and nearby, but instead of running over to help with the mech, he'll just farm for a moment here. What a crazy fight. Wow.
That was a pretty heads-up smoke there, too, just to get rid of the bugs, maybe worried about possible sun strikes and stuff. Just, you know, you're never quite sure of the cooldowns and stuff during the fights. You never know what's coming. Just guarantee that vision gets destroyed. Yeah, back in we go here. So that all kicks off with what? Darkseer and then the Weaver end up being killed by RML, which was pretty sick. But back in the pit we go.
No Ravage anymore. And back wall's back up at 12. Omni Slash isn't available for 55. They do have the Invoker Agate Scepter, but he gets frostbitten. Telekinesis comes out. Fly Soul looking for his stun. And they're going to find Hana quickly, but he's got the mech vacuum back still. The wall was there, but he just got it. And he will fall before he uses it. Desama, he was frostbitten. Armel getting caught. Raji time lapses away. Boombox doesn't have his ultimate. Fade Bolt, Sunstrike on point again for Teehee. And now they're overrunning Clutch Gamers. They're going to find at least one kill with Obbing auto attacking that to pour Rubick down. Raji, frostbitten up Stormhammer. This should bring him down, and it will. Flysel, still very tanky with the Warcry. He just had his urn, but it will fall. A double kill for Obbing, but here comes the Pulse Snap. EMP, now the Freezing Field again on Teehee. He's in trouble. Can they auto-attack him down? They'll get this kill. Obbing gets the triple. It's four dead on both sides. Psyonix the last to live. A triple for Obbing, a double for Psyonix. And Boombox does it again, Trent.
Dude, this guy is the CM master.
He really is.
He's nice. He's level 12.
He's like trying to solo Psyonix, who has Omni Slash now. So Boombox is like, no, I don't want to fight you.
He's the same level as his Drow and his Darkseer now after that fight.
How much net worth did he get out of that? He's 1,000 gold behind the Tide, so he's still a little bit poor, but he's getting a Midas, so that's going to be rectified. Are we going to finally see Roche get taken? I mean, it's still below half HP. It's been some battling-ass freaking fights around this Roche pit, let me tell you.
Well, now we have Ravage back up.
Yeah, and they smoke too. This is a dangerous time for Clutch Gamers. That might just lead them to losing a big team fight and losing the game just based off of it alone. But right now, it looks like it'll just be Hana. He'll surge himself away. Breaks the smoke of Psyonix. They're chasing after him. That's huge. If Geek Fam take a fight there and go the opposite direction towards mid, or get at least one kill, it becomes very problematic. They might find Boombox.
I think this should go to Geek Fam. Like, with the medallion up on the Weaver, the Invoker control, Ravage. Yeah, I think they should. I mean, they want that pickoff smoke, which is understandable, but
Hana doesn't have TP for 5. I think you just TP. I think he needs to TP. It's easy for us to say with that, but
yeah.
Raji's going to come in, and he's probably dead unless he TPs now. Ravage for this? No, I guess not. That's the better play. If they ravaged that, I would have been very surprised.
Yeah. Top tower is under that would attack. Probably not be good.
All right, man.
Lowers your Roche control potential. Oh, he TP'd right to mid, though. It's a nice play.
Yeah, they've done a very good job of...
This is very smart. Like, okay, we'll head it, like... We have this vision around the area anyway. We know you're not in Roche right now. We're drawing you all here. Look at this Iron Shell creep just chasing.
It's the Frost Mage. Our friend is back. The vacuum, the gust is there, but he got the Kraken Shell. and that will mean that he actually gets it off. There we go, spin, there's the wall, drop down, doesn't really do much. Sunstrike Boombox, I don't think he's going to get off a freezing field this fight. Maybe he will, time lapse back. Raji does actually avoid all that damage. However, Armel about to get EMP'd. He's got wand charges, he'll use them. Stormhammer onto Psionics, he's got Omni Slash. Meanwhile, Raji getting auto attack down. So far, Clutch Gamer's kind of on the back foot here. DD, pick it up. He gets it. He might die still. They don't have detection. Vacuum back in. Nicely done. Raji's up to the shrine. I don't think he fight this. Armel is going to use the Shadow Blade now. Stormhammer gets disjointed. They don't have the detection. So a bit of an awkward engagement, and it leads Geek Fam sort of towards this Roche again, who's pretty much back to full HP at this point in time. But a weird fight, Trent. Very strange.
I can't believe Roche. He's regen so much, actually. Damn.
I think he's, like, super annoyed that he just keeps getting hit. They don't even do the courtesy of killing the guy. They just keep hurting him over and over.
He does lead a pretty awful life, honestly.
I mean...
they'll just come in, they kill you.
He
they're
can
not
move,
nice.
Though, right? He can
they
move
take
out
your
to
cheese.
Somewhere else, like...
Can he, though? I mean, he's tried to move, and then they keep following him. First, he was, like,
depends.
Over here, and then he was here, and now he's moved over here. And people still keep showing up and killing him. He, like, moved across country.
He really
and they still
to get
show
out of
up.
This box canyon, is what I'll call it. Because actually, if you look at the sides of the Dota map, there's no way he's making it out anytime soon. He's pretty much caged in.
Well, what about
cage.
Those wings, dude? Do you not? Those they don't work.
Those are chicken wings, man. He can't fly with those.
That's just decorative.
Have you ever seen Roche fly once before?
Well, I mean, that's why I'm asking.
Yeah, I don't think he's making it out. I don't remember what the Warcraft 3 model was, but I don't think he's making it out anymore.
I just like how his. In the new model, his, like, pit is his head, you know? It's like
oh,
a
yeah.
Roche head. It's cool. Like, nice one, Valve. Good meme. Little face.
They did a good job with it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make it even again.
Oh, well, kill that Rubik. Dire. Get him!
There he is. Dead, probably. Nice vacuum steal, but Armel
got that hit.
Him, dude. Yeah, he wrecked.
How much damage that did?
Whew. Shadow Blade
attack. 500 damage right click.
Yeah, that's nuts. Anyway. There's no more Dire Roche on advantage. At least there shouldn't be. They'll head into the Radiant. Boombox, I think, is dead. See ya. And...
all right. Sick Roche, guys.
It's just, again, they just can't quite find that Roshan kill. Just can't quite get it. So, let me ask you a question.
I think, well, I'll just say, I think Teehee is just, like, killing himself right now that he bought this blink before the bots. And you know, it might be the blink that made it so that they haven't had to have this, you know, this Roche battle because he's so mobile and stuff and that they can keep delaying it. But my God, if he had bots this whole time, he could have been punishing so hard. Anyway, continue.
Well, that leads me to the question of who has the late game? And I'm inclined to believe it's going to be Clutch Gamers because at some point in time, this Fen becomes either A, big, or B, he buys an Aghanim Scepter. Either of which, I don't know what's going to happen, but at some point, Ravage is not going to be a big issue. Jug is going to be Jug.
So what does support Sven do, basically?
Right, that and who has the late game type of question, I suppose.
I probably, it's fairly even, I would say. I kind of favor Geek Fam a bit. I think Tide actually is pretty sick late game, especially with an Invoker. Like, you get into that Refresher, and it's just overall like, ridiculous dankness. Double Ravage, pretty good spell. That's kind of like the ultra late game and stuff, though. But, like, mid late, probably going to favor CG.
Yeah, I was going to say. Maybe you have a BKB up or something along those lines and can avoid the Ravages. And really... the question that you posed, which I'm very interested in, is what does this Fen do? Where does he go from here?
Yeah, you basically just, like, blink. You blink stun, and,
that's
kind of it. I kind of like four staff builds and stuff after this, but we'll see what he opts into.
So he didn't end up going the Midas either, which means that he can't really build into that aggressive Sven late game type thing. I think it's just going to be more control. Good scan from Radiant.
He right, should probably just buy the wards and let Boombox get a BKB, honestly.
I mean, the way Boombox is playing, he might as well. Like, yeah. He's had very few missed freezing fields and some sick freezing fields that have killed TP twice. He's just like, can you not do that? Armel is sitting in the trees, let me tell you. There's a lot of control pings happening here.
They are very concerned about these mud golems.
That was Armel's pings, by the way. Just pinging at the mud golems, like, don't let them die. Micro them, push them. And Psionic Smoke is broken. And it's back into the Roche Pit, but guess who's there? It's a Hellbear. Ahoy.
Well, they are considering going up for this. What's our initiation? Blink Sven will be the dream here.
And they want a vacuum, so Psionic's gonna get caught. Storm Hammer. Yeah, let's just play through. They need, like, an easy. But now it's time to leave. Hana, still invised up. Teehee, Ghost Walk is there. They drop the sentry. They know where he is. Armel also Shadowbladed. Requiem getting canceled. Blink Ravage comes in. Gusts out. Vacuum Wall. Two initiations at once so far. Abi has to get to the low ground. The freezing kill. Boombox is there. Can they bring anybody down? Abi Slash going, no. It's Blade Fury. They get the kill onto Boombox. No, he's still alive. Meanwhile, Tide. Heal fall. Psionic. Yeah, see you later. Probably. Yep. Oh, the Abi Slash. I don't know if that's going to save him. Meanwhile, Armel gets a double kill on the other side of Urn. He's very fast. TP not going to make it in time. The auto attack is there for Fly Solo. Wow. Attack. I can't believe this turned so poorly for Geek Bam.
I mean, did you see how that fight started?
That was really weird.
That was sick. It was, you have Requiem. Let's say, trade Storm Hammer. Nice.
It's like a Lotus Warp type trade.
I'm sure we'll head to the Rush Pit, so we'll just do our diagram here. It's like there's that little high ground, and you've got a Requiem down here, and you have a Crystal Maiden up here. So like, boom and boom, and they were just all in the middle, right outside the Rush Pit. It looked kind of bad.
I was going to the place where the fight actually happened.
Oh no, I was drawing it by the pit. It was just like, it's just kind of crazy.
Do it again. Draw it again. Right around the pit.
Oh, okay. Well, see, we had this high ground, like the bounty room's here, right? And then you have CM ulting there, and then you have Requiem down here, and they were all in here.
And then the Ravage was like, the Ravage is over here in this area.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. John Madden the shit out of that thing, man. We just John the shit out of that fight. What a play.
It's just two massive ultimates both working together, and there's our BKB now for SF. So this is the most powerful moment, I would guess, for CG. This next, like, 5-10 minutes or so. And then as the Invoker starts to level up, and if, like, Psionic, maybe he can start to abuse spin TPs around the map. That might be a way for them to stay in it for Geek Fam. Just let your Invoker and your Jug stacking in control. Let this Weaver scale up a bit. Actually get this Aghanim Scepter. Probably around the timing Raji has the Aghanim Scepter, they'll be stronger again on Geek Fam. So I think there is, like, a window here where CG need to really start putting in the pressure. I mean, they have the 10k lead. Just use that and, like, close out the game, but it's definitely not over.
Man, it was much closer with that 4k lead that they had before the team fight happened. It suddenly spiraled out of control. I'm wondering why Hana hasn't picked up the Guardian Greaves. He had 3,000 gold, and clearly he wants the Crimson Guard instead, which is not a bad idea.
Yeah, I think with the Jug, it's very good against Omni Slash. It's gonna be like a secondary war cry. They're just like doubling down on this physical resistance.
Ravage is back up now, but again with Aegis and the lead that Clutch Gamers have, I'd be very surprised to see Geek Fam make any aggressive plays other than pushing waves out and trying to find a pick or two. But like you mentioned, there is this window of time here. Drow wants to finish up this man's style, and that's probably going to be what they're waiting for. Any other big amount of gold? Shadow Fiend has a bit, but he just purchased up his BKB, so I think once they have this Mantis Style, as it's flying out now, or actually, he still needs the recipe. Once they have this recipe for the Mantis Style, oh, maybe not. They're just going to go instead with the Ultimate Orb. They would wait a bit further, but they want to pounce upon BKM, take the opportunity in their hands, and do the best that they can with it. We'll see what happens.
Shadowblade's running. Yeah, it's back in 2 seconds, but Armel won't have it.
Brings out Shadowblade coming in from Armel. Psionic, Stormhammer, good spin. Gust comes too late. Frostbite is up for Boombox. Good purge.
Oh, nice defusal.
Very good purge. Backing back, though, and I think he's done anyway. Zombie Slash is there, but it wouldn't have saved his life. So that's a huge pickup. That is the biggest kill besides TE that you could have gotten.
I had to double check that Hannah didn't take the 100 cast range, which he did not. He took the evasion at level 10. That was a massive vacuum. That was like maximum range. Crimson should be fine.
Yeah, good team. But now they push. I also frostbite the Sanctuary Conqueror. That's going to get dropped. But dead Jug for 30 seconds. They can put a little bit of pressure on the high ground. They'll force Glyph, potentially. Meanwhile, Teehee, this is what you were talking about. Splitting the map, using Boots of Travel to your advantage. Also doing the same as Raji down bottom. He doesn't have bots. He has a TP ready. He really wants the Zagatip Scepter, as you talked about. Tier 3 tower, though. Jump in. Tornado EMP. He has Aegis. Gets forced forward.
Oh, I love this. He sold his Blightstone and his wand to buy the Aghanims because they wanted for this fight so badly. I think that's definitely the play.
And this is going to be very interesting how this goes. They steal Warcry, by the way, which is pretty huge.
That is, actually. That's a really nice steal.
Strong fight. Blade Fury comes out. Deathsama does have his Ravage ready if he wants it. The Glimmer Cape. Hurricane Pike going. Deathsama's like, please don't hit me. He's off the shrine now. Frost Arrow's coming in. They really want to make sure he doesn't get that Blink Ravage off. Another shrine going. Telekinesis Armel. Shadowblade's out. The Gush is there. Glimmer Cape as well. But they have the vision. Age is gone. Back wall. It's ready. And it's time. Hana looking for Crimson. He'll fall first. Maybe. 26 HP. Might narrowly escape. Blink Ravage. It's going to be on to four. Jumping in Stormhammer. Great Deafening Blast Meatball combo. They've lost Hana. Requiem will come through. It's the Freezing Field as well. And Teehee.
Nice.
Great time lapse back coming up to Weaver, but it might not be enough. Down for 77. Omnislash jumping through. Psionics is going to fall yet again. He has buyback.
Oh, dude.
And they've already taken the racks down. They can leave happy with what they've accomplished. Obby's going back. He wants Crimson. He'll find him. One FL miss will not save his life. Now there's the Hurricane Bike, so Obby can get back. Glimmer Cape will come through. Tornado, EMP combo, fly solo, gets a two-man stun off. He's low in HP, but he wants to scale on Raji. Good time lapse, just in time, but Armel, he'll find the Invoker, and that is a dieback. And that might be the end of this game, the end of this series. They'll try to go top racks. Luckily, they only have three heroes alive, so GeekFam might actually still be able to do something here.
Let me hit you with some numbers here.
All right.
In that fight where they took the racks, do you know who did the most damage that fight? It was Shadow Fiend. He did 4,200 damage. Do you know who did the next most?
Who?
It was Crystal Maiden. 3,037. Yeah. I had the Drow, the Darkseer, the support spell. I mean, Boombox is just... I had these ulties, dude.
He's godlike. Every time, he just gets them off.
It's like, Raji,
too.
It was a sick time lapse trying to save Teehee, but he just gets time lapsed back into
the
Freezing Field.
They have to cancel it, I feel like, but he just does it at such opportune times where all of their abilities are down. He, like, waits for everything to get thrown out, and he's like, all right, guys, it's time. And boy, I want to see how much damage he's done at the end of this game, because it's probably going to be up there.
Yeah, it's actually going to be for sure near the top. But double melees, definitely the potential closest here. 2-0 from Clutch Gamers. I mean, great team, but certainly not really expected if they can actually finish this one out here. Was thinking we'd be getting ourselves the old, you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
The 2-1, the game three.
The good old game three. The old, you know what I'm trying to say. Oh, Trent.
Woo, Mr.
This is
Cat.
One of those days, man. You're enjoying life. You got a CM that you can really just enjoy watching, and sometimes.
Oh, good
stuff. I'm not going to talk about it anymore. That made me laugh, though. Thank you for that.
No problem. I got you. That's what I'm here for.
It is going to be. What's the lead looking like here? 20,000? Boy. That's not great. Geek fam. That's not great.
Nice.
And they have a butterfly now for Shadow Fiend as well. Like you said, this is a very Clutch Gamers to 2-1 Warriors Gaming to 2-0 Geek Fam. These are some big names on both of these teams. If Clutch Gaming wins, who will they play up against? The winner of Faceless and the Mineski TNC, I think, right?
Yes. So, Clutch win this, and yeah, it'll be Faceless versus whoever, yeah. Mineski, TNC, the winner of that. So, potentially, it's either going to be Faces or Mineski or TNC. So, three very strong teams.
Yeah.
And, again, they'll have to prove their merit.
That's the, I would say, harder side of the bracket, considering the teams there. Well, let's not count our chickens before they come to roost, or some BS proverb, I guess. We'll just throw it there.
But, well said. Very.
I tried.
Oh, he actually bought another wand on Raji. He's like, hey, you know, I really needed that item, actually. I had to sell for my eggs, but I got to go back to that 30-minute wand.
Sometimes you need stick charges, man.
Yep.
He didn't just get the stick; he just got the full wand too. He wants those. He wants those four attributes. It's really not that bad, actually. Nice to have early on in the game. It's not really early though; it's 33 minutes in. But I think they're waiting for Roche, Trent, I would imagine.
Yes.
That's the play.
It's definitely the flowchart Dota play.
And, well, Clutch Gamers, they've gone by the flowchart for both this series and the last one yesterday. The unfortunate thing for Clutch Gamers is, however, they have to wait 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, in fact, for Roshan to respawn. So, a frustrating situation for them. Not as frustrating as it is for Geek fans. Anyway.
Yeah, I'm seeing if we have any exciting items going on here, but not too much. I mean, Flat Solo, he's an aura. Right? I Warcry, I drums, I check out some urns. This is my life now.
A golden thread.
And that's pretty much it. And wow. Geez, speaking of auras. Rappy now building into the pipe, so he'll have the Greaves, he'll have the Crimson Guard. Got his helm, he's gonna have the full pipe. This is the dream Darkseer build. This is like, come with me, team. I will guide you.
I got your backs, guys.
This is like so many buffs, they can't even fit on the screen. Kind of a hero.
Mm-hmm. They are in a very good spot. Linked Sphere. Invoker, that's not gonna save you from the freezing field, my man. That's not gonna save you from the doom that is the Crystal Maiden.
The real concerns here. Yeah.
I'm kind of memeing it up, but I'm also half serious while I'm saying this. I think you know. It's a very real possibility that just.
It's true. It really doesn't do that much this game. It's like, just don't Stormhammer me. And that's pretty much it. Don't Frostbite me.
This is it. This is their time. Geekfim, they want to kill before Roshan is up. They can't afford to give this Aegis away. They know this. They will start by walking out.
Well, they actually will find Armel.
Armel, Shadowbladed up though. Where's the detection? Oh my god. See you later, Rubik. Requiem Deathsome on that blade mail will not save you. Ravage is not going to come out. They do have buyback on these heroes. Raji's sitting behind the trees. He doesn't want anything to do with this. EMP comes out. So TV Gerber will retreat the tornado as well. Boombox is like, if I had a blink dagger, I would have got you guys.
That Lincoln saved him.
What do you know?
He living.
Yeah, so the Rubik got two shot. I don't know if you saw it, but
he got annihilated. I was like looking to see him put down the sentry, and he like barely got it down in time.
God, dude. He hit like a truck. Gus just missing the Xeonix. He actually sidesteps to the left. Double buyback.
Abort.
Time to get out. Roche is up just about now, so I think they just smoked on top of this board, by the way. They know this because it's Gemma fly solo. They really just wanted to get out quicker. Armel does take a tornado, actually does some significant damage. He'll be annoyed.
Drow hits for 420 damage.
No, that's not fun.
No. The wolf just following her around. And they have nothing left in two lanes. And now no Roche to try and find.
Here's the smoke. All right, Geek Fam, you got Ravage up. It's time to go. But guess what? There's a scan, and they know something's happening here. Han is like, I am ready.
He's in.
Oh, the blink, the vacuum wall combo, the freezing field. Oh, see you later, Geek Fam. You're donezo. This series is over. Clutch Gamers just won it with Han's blind blink vacuum wall. Yeah, I would GG there, too.
Wow. Dude,
Jesus,
he was in.
Jesus H. Christ.
Radiant. All right, first series of the day. It's a banger. Clutch taking 0. Unexpected victory up against Geek Fam. The odds were certainly not in their favor.
All right, let's look. Hey, Trent, it's the moment of truth. Guess how much, don't look at it. Guess how much damage the CM did.
All right, tell me how much the SF did first.
All right, the SF did, let's see, 21,000 damage.
CM did 12.5.
No, he did more than that, actually.
Oh, really? 15?
15.8.
Oh, damn, dude. Look at that.
His second amount of damage on his team, more than the Drow Ranger, by 4K. Boombox is a god.
What is it, dude? This guy's the CM player.
I could see why
he's level 20, dude.
That's nuts.
Wow.
I got to say, that last fight was something else. That was real good. A real good fight. It kind of just put the cap on the game that really Clutch Gamers were looking for. And again, they're down at the beginning of the game by about a K or two, not anything too significant. And then all of a sudden, it gets out of control. Clutch Gamers are able to take that window, that 10-minute window at the after that 10-minute mark and just go to work. I mean, Trent, what else is there to say? They did very well. I don't know.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So, we'll have a little bit of a breather here, guys. About an hour until the next series will start.
An hour. Whew.
Well, you should... You'll have to play your game.
Make some coffee.
Or make some coffee. You can do that, too.
Yeah, I was going to get some food, actually.
Yeah. No, fine. Be that way.
Okay.
Good. All right, guys. Well, we'll be back in like an hour. You can. I'm sure we'll have a little timer going. We have the technology now.
Yes,
I hear.
Yes, don't worry, Trent. I'll get the timer going.
Yeah, you got that going. You the man. Right. And it'll be WG Unity versus MVP Hot 6 elimination match.
Ooh. We'll come back for that best of three in about an hour, guys. We'll see you
soon. What if we did a whole lower bracket as elimination mode? My God. All right. That's our next tournament. Oh, my God. Fucking genius.
But isn't that just EM, but with...
No, but only lower bracket. So whenever it's elimination, you play elimination mode.
I mean, I get it.
Ah, all right, guys. We'll be back in like an hour.
See you guys.
Genius.